when Napoleon lay at Boulogne for a year with his flat bottom boats and his grand army, he was told by someone, there are bitter weeds in England. There are certainly a great many more of them since the British expeditionary force returned. Sir, I have myself full confidence that if all do their duty, if nothing is neglected, and if the best arrangements are made, as they are being made, we shall prove ourselves once more able to defend our island home, to ride out the storm of war, and to outlive the menace of tyranny, if necessary for years, if necessary alone. At any rate, that is what we are going to try to do. That is the resolve of His Majesty's government, every man of them. That is the will of Parliament and the nation, the British Empire and the French Republic, linked together in their cause and in their need, will defend to the death their native soil, aiding each other like good comrades to the utmost of their strength. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And if, which I do not for a moment believe, this island or a large part of it were subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet, carry on the struggle until in God's good time, the new world with all its power and might steps forth to the rescue and the liberation.
Yo guys, what is up? Fly here. Welcome back to the channel. So, for the second video in the row, we're going to continue the British bias with Zihid or Ziad. Try the British heavy tank Matilda. It's not really played much nowadays. Apparently, there's a lot of debate on whether this is a heavy tank, a medium tank, or an assault tank, infantry tank. It's a tank. So, good. You know, we're on the same page. So at 3.0, this thing is a beast. We have some very amazing armor for a 3.0 tank, but once we get upclassed to that 3.3 versus the German 75, even the T-34 gun, this thing gets pretty shat on, unless we angle. However, you know, there's only so much we can do with this turret. There's a lot of neck room that they can shoot us. We're just going to have to be lucky that the player doesn't know our weak spots when we're angled and we get a low BR match. Now, looking at this armor, check it out, man. 75 millimeters for a 3.0 tank. Fucking tough. Turret, 75 and trolley. What I mean by trolley is that you move your mouse a little bit and then look at that right there. Look at that. 375 effective thickness. Now, that's like the worst place to shoot, but you can see, like, if our turret's angled, there's a lot of places for that round just to bounce off. 220 at 100, you know, so the turret is very trolly, and that's going to benefit us. I was talking a little bit early about this neck. As you can see, the neck is pretty massive. A smart player who's close enough to me is going to shoot right through here, and as you can see, oh man, one shot and done. One shot and done. Once that neck gets penetrated, we are pretty fucked up. But one thing that's really concerning me that for some reason I haven't realized in the past is this part right here. 78 millimeters of armor that protects the driver, as you can see, and pretty much hopefully the tank, which is better than our upper plate, if you want to call it that, and our turret armor. But then you look over to the left and right and it's only 22 millimeters of armor. That can't be. And when you look at the design of the tank, you can see the welding. I honestly think these things are just welded on to make the tank look symmetrical-ish, even though this thing's not symmetrical at all. Well, at least the add-ons to it and the headlights. But still, I think and hope, let me know in the comments below, because I can't find the armor value here. But I feel like it's like 47 millimeters sloped. Because why would they create this huge, massive plate here and then completely neglect these sides? But what I think happens is that people, well, if someone were trying to shoot here, they would easily penetrate the 22 millimeters of armor, but then bounce off this slope here. I don't know. Because if that's the case, and hopefully we'll bounce from that spot today and I'll, you know, have the answer, or we'll die from it and then we'll be playing this thing hold down. But we'll have to wait and see. Let me know in the comments below if we don't experience a situation like that in today's video. I would really love to know. And then we got the side armor. Probably some of the most trolliest side armor in the world, or at least in this game. We have a very strong hole right here, or upper hole. But even if you try to shoot through here, you got a lot of stuff to work through. You got 25 millimeters of armor, then you got this thing, then you got this thing, then you got that thing, then you got... There's some more bullshittery in here. And then you got the chassis, or the structural steel, the chassis 20 millimeters. Then you got the hole, which if I can get to it, I think I just got to it right there, 40 millimeters. So this thing, if we're not facing 135 millimeter pen gun, we can really bounce some shots today. And I hope we can experience that. Guys, let's keep the good times rolling. In the comments below, let me know what you guys want to see next. All right, let's get started. Welcome to the battle. We are on Fields of Normandy, checking our VR spread. It looks like we're top tier. However, even though we feel that we're 3.0, doesn't negate the fact that the other team could have a 3.3. Sometimes it just works out like that. I think we should be good. At least we're not going to be facing any 75 millimeter turreted German cannons. So one thing that we really didn't touch on in the intro is the Matilda's gun. And that's because the Matilda's not really known for its gun, or people really don't like to talk about the gun. Now, the gun's not bad, but the gun doesn't really perform well. And just bear with me, it doesn't perform well very quickly. So you have a 40 millimeter round that doesn't shrapnel well. Sometimes, even if it penetrates, it doesn't kill crew. But what it does have going for it, Jesus Christ. The target hasn't taken any damage. Like that, look at that. But what it does do well is fire rate. We're angling right now, trying to I think that's a 75. Yeah, he's not going to be able to do anything to us unless he uses heat. Track's gone. Good hit. Need one more like that. Come on. Another bounce. Another bounce. Angle. Good. This has just got pretty hot and heavy right now. We got a Panzer III or Panzer IV in front of us. We're pushing up to C. Where are you, dude? You just shot. Come back. Come out. We got to keep that right side unlocked. We don't want to push too far up and give and expose our left side. There we go. Yes, a hit. Good hit. Keep pushing up. Check our right side. Looks good. Where's that Panzer? I see one to my right. We're gonna focus him. Good. Angle this way. Ooh, shit. What the fuck just got through that? What the fuck is that? Is that APCR? Damn. 18. Good. Thank you, M22, for the help right there. We got one guy behind this house. Let me see if I can push him hard. Whoa, whoa. Whoa. Where the fuck did he hit me right there? We're gonna start repairing? Oh, he has a heat round. Got him, though. We need to check after this game what the Panzer IV heat round is. Pretty tough for the Matilda. We have taken some pretty devastating hits. We lost a good portion of our crew. At least, well, we only have two crew members left. So that completely destroys our capabilities of firing fast. Now we're going to have to be super accurate. I'm going to see if we can get into C, cap it, and then repair one of our crew members. Okay, we got an enemy trying to capture C. I think it's a Panzer III. Let's not extend too much. We have that... Oh, shit. Good, nice one shot right there. That was some good shrapneling. I think I hear him. He just shifted. Come on, baby. Ooh, we're going to balance this. This will be tough. We got to balance this. Fuck. Yes, go for that gunner. Good, one down. Thought he might have been there, but he wasn't. If I was him, I would be trying to flank, but he's not flanking. Poor shot right there. Couldn't get the gun down fast enough. Got him. Okay, capturing C. Good fight right there, Panzers. Pulling back. We got another enemy pushing up. Anti-air. I wonder if we can get some nice shots here. Wow. Okay. I'll take that. Enemy to the right, potentially? I don't know what this guy is hitting, but he's hitting armor. I can hear it bounce off. I think he's this way. Let's push out. Oh, shit. Japanese. Dangerous. Wow, that was horribly played by us. Lower glacis, can we get through? Nah, I'm not going to try it. There we go. Good. Okay, now we're recapping. Thankfully, his gun wasn't able to penetrate our side armor. We weren't even angled. We just got really lucky right there. Okay, now we're capturing C. We're going to repair the crew. And this game is looking like a victory for us. Buck, yes, welcome to Valo Calams in a perfect setup for the Matilda. Now, one thing I didn't talk about last game is the gun depression. We have negative 20 gun depression for this thing, which is phenomenal for this map. As you can see, there's some pretty big incline or hills leading up to the battle. We're going to play near the A side, though we're going to have to be a little passive because, unfortunately, we don't have the speed to get there in time to get to that good position. So we're going to have to go up to this hill, camp it out, shoot some people, and then push in. But yeah, last game was a lot of fun. It's very rare in War Thunder that you play a tank and you're able to neutralize two enemy tanks one after the other. And that's what this gun does really well. It doesn't one-shot well, but it does dissect crew. And so you can shoot gunner, then you can shoot the driver, and they're just sitting there helpless. Very good pen for this tier. Though at range, it does dissipate heavily, as you can see. So we have passed A and B without any resistance. Ivan's still trying to help me get up this hill here. Tango front. Look at that depression. Beautiful. Another one. The driver. And go right for here. Later. Okay, now how did this guy just die? The right looks clear. We have some range. I feel like someone's right in front of me. Might have one guy right here. Hit him. Don't know what it is, though. It didn't call it out. Really? Oh, shit. Guys, where was this guy? One shot. Hey! Fuck yeah. Fucking sneaky Stoog. Okay, we're good. I guess keep pushing up. We only have two kills, too. When you try your best, but you... No, I'm... Oh! That was the biggest fucking bomb I've ever seen in War Thunder. It looked like a fucking fat-ass dildo. We might return the favor. Oh, wow. Look at this. Do you guys think we can do this right here? Everyone just stop moving. There you go. Good. We'll drop two right there. They look all right. See, 500-pound bombs, they don't like to do anything. We're going to try it again. We're going to be more accurate this time. Look at how many tanks there are right here, though. Bomb away. Okay, here comes mine. Those look pretty damn accurate to me. Oh, yeah. Only one. Nice and balanced. So the Germans came back. They just captured C, and now they're capturing B. Early game, it was a full stomp. Tank. Beautiful shot. Didn't even kill this driver, even though the round penetrated right there. But the shrapnel did get his gunner. So, I mean, yeah, I mean, this round has some shrapneling, but don't rely on it. Rely on dissecting the enemies. Now, these were the guys that I was trying to bomb earlier, I believe. Got a Stug. Got a gunner. Good. Ah, we couldn't. There we go. We got that. One guy over here. Let's use this thing's depression. Come on, Matildi. Go for that driver first. Oh, he's dead. Okay, now where... We got a Panzer IV. Reload. And... Beautiful. Pushing up. We're in B now. Hopefully no bombers are here. I think we got some more anti-air. Enemy tank. Good hit. Holy shit. Need to go more for the left, but I can't penetrate. Actually, we just... No, I think we hit the side. We couldn't penetrate that angle right there. Now, we gotta watch our right, because they did capture C earlier. However, I don't really see any other enemy tanks. Alright, good. We're about to capture C. Or, excuse me, B. And we're gonna sit right here and wait for them. I might have to go on... Shit. Damn it, we botched that up. So what I'm going to do is, instead of going to C, because I've got a lot of ground to climb, I'm going to head over to A, because at least I can stay kind of flat and on a nice road. Now this Panzer IV that we were shooting at earlier definitely has his gunner up and his engine fixed. Let's see if we just can't surprise him here. Angle. Ah, fuck you. Come on, dude. Right there it happened. We shot right for the gunner, but the round did absolutely nothing to him. We're gonna clutch it in the 3-inch gun carrier. Trust me. They're trying to capture B now. I'm gonna head in there. Whoa, whoa. Wow. 75mm AP does not fuck around. We're gonna head into B, cap that, and hopefully head over to A. Hopefully my team can hold the left side. And I think we have a Japanese tank in here that we were shooting at earlier. Don't see him. Where'd he fucking go? Got him in sight. We're gonna push this guy. God damn it. So guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Comments below. Let me know what you guys want to see next. Guys, have a great day. Until next time, see you Sunday. Peace out.